We're about to split a 9 or 10 minute video into some smaller videos right now using Descript. Splitting long form video into smaller, shorter videos, whether it's for YouTube Shorts or Instagram Reels or any other platform, pretty straightforward. But I'm sure we'll hit some roadblocks along the way, and we'll figure out how to get around them. Let's get started. If you don't have Descript yet, there's a link in the description. You can get started for free and stay on the free tier as long as you want. The free tier has plenty of features and capacity to let you figure out whether it's something you really like or not. Full disclosure, I may receive a commission at no extra cost to you if you use my link. The first thing that I'm going to do here is go over to the canvas, and in the upper left, this is the aspect ratio. So we're going to drop this down, and we're going to go from the landscape that we are currently in, we're going to switch it to portrait, the 9x16, rather than the 16x9. Then I'm going to click on my video here, and I'm just going to drag it out. I need this to be big enough to fill the screen. So we'll go to there, we've got the screen full, and I want to center it. That tends to work out the best if I just center this video once I've changed the aspect ratio, and then we can make some finer adjustments as we go. The reason I like to do that first is because then that's going to apply across everything we do once we split this up. If we split it up first, then we might have to do that step over and over again, and I don't really want to do that. I know I don't want the intro for the long form video, so we're going to go ahead and get rid of that. Fortunately, this is a top 10 video, so each one of the pieces starts off with number one, number two. That makes it nice and easy to find where we're going to split this video. First things first, we're going to get rid of this introduction. I'm going to go ahead and select all that. And then when this menu pops up, I'm going to hit this strike through, which is ignore. I'm going to ignore that text. And then I'm going to go to the bottom, because I'm sure there's a outro of some sort. So we're going to find it. And that is right here. Select it, ignore, got rid of that. I'm going to put a marker everywhere we're going to split the video. And this will be really handy because when we go to export, we can say export by markers. And if we end up with 10 different markers, then Descript will export 10 different videos. And we'll be able to do that just all at once. The way to do this is within the script panel over here, where we want the marker. For instance, I want one right before number one, billionaire house. I'm going to press M on the keyboard and it'll insert this that says marker. And I am just going to type right over that. That one is called Billionaire House. Good. And what you might notice over here on the left, it's inserted this marker right here that says Billionaire House. And it'll be a little more obvious as we get a few more in here. So let's go down number two. And I just click to the left of that. I'm going to press M on the keyboard. And then I'm going to change the name. I don't have to select it or anything. It selects the word marker as soon as you put the marker in. So I can just start typing. So that's good. That one's done. You notice that it added the marker up here on the left. I'll go through here and do these to the rest. Go to the left of where I want the marker, press the M, start typing my marker name. You could just make these marker names number one, number two, three, four, or whatever. When you export by markers, Descript will use whatever name the marker is as the file name. So that's why I like to go ahead and make them something that makes sense. Okay, we've got all these markers added. If we click on the marker over in the scene rail, it'll take us right to that section of the video. It's pretty spiffy. If the sections you're picking are really clean and there's nothing you need to do, you could go ahead and export from here. For me, at least, that is rarely going to be the case. Another thing we want to do here is everywhere we're creating a marker, we want to split that into a separate scene. And you can do that at the same time where you're creating a marker. You just hit the forward slash as well and break it up into a scene. I did the markers first. I'm going to go back now and put scenes in everywhere that there's a marker. We have our initial scene here. You can see that by the forward slash, and then it's over in the scene rail. Here's where we added our marker for Billionaire House, the first short form video we want to create. I'll just go right above that, and I'll click in here and put in a forward slash. Oh, we ended up with two. So I have a forward slash, and that starts a new scene at Billionaire House. And there you can see it in your scene rail over on the left. I'll click the marker for the Homely Hills, and right above Homely Hills, I will do another forward slash. That'll start a new scene right there. And then click the marker. I'm right above it. Put in a forward slash. We've got a new scene. So I'm going to go through and finish doing all the scenes here. I ended up with a total of 11 scenes. Each one of them has a marker, and 11 is the right number because the first scene is that intro stuff that we're not using. So this up here is the first scene, and then marker number one actually lines up with scene number two. We can click on the scene now, and it'll take us right to the right place in the script, and we want to see what it sounds like.
Billionaire House, the 38,000 square foot palace developed by Bruce Makowski.
Okay, I took out the number one because originally this was a top 10 video, but now I'm splitting out and I'm just featuring each one of these properties in its own short form. So I don't really want to say number one. I made sure that without that as part of the sentence, it did it flow okay. And yeah, it'll be fine. Now, what I don't like about this, and you can see this start to come in if I just click word by word, I don't really have to replay it to see it. You can see we're getting this lower third title that comes in that made perfect sense in the long form, but it doesn't make so much sense here in the short form. So we're going to fix that. There's a couple of ways around it. If you have something else that you wanted to put down here, you could insert a shape, say a rectangle, to cover it up. You could make this really fancy if you wanted to, and then put a title on here by just going to title and drop, oops, grab everything here. Hey, slow down on me, man. There we go. You could grab this title and change it to a different color. That's one way you could cover up title in motion graphics from a previous video. I'm going to do something a little bit different. I'm going to click on the canvas here on this scene, and then I'm going to add an animation. So I'll click plus over there, and I'm going to do custom. And look down in the timeline. It's showing me the animation is going to start right here. It's going to end right there. If you've used other video editors, this is pretty much like a keyframe. What it's looking at is right here at this moment in time, which you can see where it is in your script and on your canvas. It all lines up. What do you want to happen here? Where do you want this to be? And then when you're at this point between these two words and you're at this point in the timeline, where do you want this scene to be? So how are we going to use that? Well, we're going to come back here to this first scene. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take where this text is. I'm going to scoot over out of the way and find a spot. We're going to start there. I'm telling Descript through this animation, I want you to start with it looking like this. And then when you get to here, you can see there where the video is centered. So it's going to start off to the right. And what's happening there is that the text is over to the left. So what I'm trying to do is take this video and be looking at the right side of the video while that text is happening over on the left, and then pan over to it so that we never see that text. Let's hit play and see how that worked.
House, the 38,000 square foot palace developed by Bruce Makowski, features 12 bed.
Okay, it came in and I don't want to see it at all. The way I'm going to fix that is I'm going to grab this end, roll it out over here so we won't get to center until about there. And we can tell, we click through our timeline here a little bit, you can get a hint of what's going to happen, but it's really just as easy to play through it. So let's play through again, see where it went.
Billionaire House, the 38,000 square foot palace developed by Bruce Makowski, features 12 bedrooms, 21 bathrooms, 17,000 square feet of outdoor deck space, 5 bars, 3.
Okay, so that seemed to do it for us. And if it disappears on you, you can find it again just by, as you can see, I don't see it here in the timeline right now. If I go up here in the properties panel, you'll see the animation that we've added, and we can just hit edit, the little pencil there, and now you can see exactly where it is. So that one did pretty good. We can scrub through. I felt like there was a blip at one point. There it is. So it's that blip is what we see down there. And the reason spreading this out worked is because you're making it take longer to get from this far right screen to this where you're in the center of the screen. So we can take that out a little bit further even if we want to completely get rid of that. Or another thing we could do is we could zoom this even bigger. Video quality may suffer depending on what you've got it recorded as, but we can start right here. We could even start with the skyline. That might be pretty cool. Let's see what that does.
House, the 38,000 square foot palace developed by Bruce Makowski, features 12 bedrooms, 21 bathrooms, 17,000.
There we go. So we got all the text out of the shot, and we even ended up with a nice little panning effect that starts up in the sky, the skyline with the mountains, and then comes down on the house. That's looking pretty good. Now let's go to the end of this one and see where it ends up. Looking good. We just want to make sure that we got our scene split in the right place and that we don't have frames from the next section of the video showing up. It's going to be its own video. It's really handy here to zoom in And you can do that by hitting these three dots above the timeline and click zoom in, or press control and equal on your keyboard. You can zoom in super deep to see really fine detail. I want to go back to where this ends. If I just drop my cursor in the script, it'll bring me in the timeline to that same place. And this looks good. Our scene is going to start here. This is scene number 3. And then this is where it's clipping. We're looking really good. We can also click right here. We can come back. And what I can see here, now notice this. I know this is the next house. This is the Humley Hills. I want to make sure those frames don't end up being a part of this video, because I wouldn't want to have this whole video go on this first house and then at the very end show an image of another house that's completely unrelated. I want to make sure that this house does not appear in that shot. So we'll just come down here where the split is. We'll make sure that we have the open bracket pointing to the left. Click and drag it back a little bit. And there we go. That'll work just fine. All right, let's take a look at our next one here. So we know we want to take out this number 2, highlight that, do the strike through to ignore it. Now let's see what that sounds like.
The Manor at Holmby Hills.
Maybe I want to warm into it instead of just stating the name. Suppose I wanted to start this off with check out the manor at Holmby Hills. I can either record that phrase right in here, or I can record it elsewhere and drop it in here. But I think what I'm going to do here is I'm going to overdub and see what that sounds like. I'm going to click right here and I'm going to say overdub, and I'm going to change the to check out the. We'll hit the overdub. Notice down here it's a flat line. The AI is doing its thing to create those words in my voice. And there it is. Now let's see how it came out.
Check out the manor at Holmby Hills.
Yeah, that's not bad. Let's see. Do that again.
Check out the manor at Holmby. Check out the manor at Holmby.
All right. It sounds like it's got a little fragment left from this number 2 over here. And so I think what we'll do, convert that to media. Now we should be able to do a little bit of editing here. We need to bring this in. See this little waveform here? That, I think, is part of number 2 that was in there before. So we're just going to drag this in a little bit. There we go. All right, now let's try that.
Check out the manor at Holmby Hills.
Yeah, that sounds pretty good. I think we'll stick with that. All right, so by now, we'll go on to the next one. Oh, I see an issue here. We've got our screen splitting and our marker between 165 and million. That's definitely a problem. We need to move that. Not sure how we ended up with that issue, but we're just going to grab this. I'm going to control X to cut the million. I'm going to go right here before this scene starts. I'm going to go ahead and do a carriage return. Control V puts the million up there. Get rid of the period here because that's just not the right place. And see where this goes.
Number 3.
Yeah, that's fine. Okay. I'm going to keep working on these basic cleanup things here to get everything looking ready. I'm just going to keep doing the same thing that we've done at every split, but you probably don't want to sit through me doing all 10 of these. So hang tight. I'll zip through this. We'll come back and get these out. Now that we have everything split up, cleaned up, and ready to go, so one more thing we might want to add here, especially for the vertical video format, is some really fancy captions or subtitles, whatever you want to call them. The way we're going to add these inside Descript, we're going to click on our canvas here, come over to the T button up in the insert menu, and click captions. And we've got some words on the screen. That's a good start. We can edit this over here under live text captions. Click the settings and we have some options. This is the last style that I used, and it is showing up as custom. We can also pick from one of the defaults, which is karaoke. And karaoke does this play.
Our house, the 38,000 square foot palace developed by Bruce Makowski.
I also have a border on this, which is, for whatever reason, outside of the captions. So I'm going to take that off.
Features 12 bedrooms, 21 bathrooms,
17,000. That's what the default captions looks like on the karaoke setting. You can also go to classic. It looks like this.
And square feet of outdoor deck space, 5 bars.
And that is just the text where it does not highlight or accent the active word. And we have clean,
3 kitchens, an 85-foot infinity pool, and a swim-up bar.
The print clean just puts up each word as it's said. You can customize any of these the way that you like. I'm going to go back and I'm going to start with karaoke. The fill on active word is the color that the text is going to be. The background under active word is what the background color is going to be when the word is being said. And then future words
the fill is what text the words that haven't been said yet will appear in. We're going to change the fill of these words. Let's go with yellow, and we'll make our future words. Oh, let's just make them white. And let's say we want our background for our active word to be black. Let's see what that looks like. Previous home that was on this lot was owned by Judy Garland until 1967. The home comes furnished and includes over 100 rare and expensive work. That will work. A little tip about putting captions on here. Keep in mind that down here at the bottom, this is where your avatar logo, icon, whatever appears. Usually somewhere down in the bottom is where the title is across, and it can be a couple of lines. Usually up along this side is the like button, the comment, and all those kinds of things. So we want to stay away from the far right, at least three quarters of the way up the screen, two thirds, I don't know. Stay away from the bottom. And then up here at the top, depending on the platform that you're on, there may be things across the top. We don't want to have our fancy subtitles be blocked or end up blocking some of these other things. Around here seems to be a decent spot to put these things.
Works of art.
And a 30. So we'll stop there. We do need to add captions to each scene. Once you've set the captions on the first scene and you've customized the way that you want them to look, the next time you go to use captions, it keeps them in the same spot and the same colors and the same style that we picked before. You want to make sure that your subtitles here are lining up with what's being said. You really should play through and see how it lines up. I noticed something that might need to be fixed, and I'm going to go ahead and zoom in using Control Plus as many times as it takes. Here, I thought we might run into a problem, and I want to see what it looks like.
The mountains and ocean. The 237-acre estate includes impressive equestrian...
Yeah, that's what I thought. So that doesn't
ocean.
Line up exactly.
The 237-acre
right.
estate,
where we're saying...
It's an ocean. The 237-acre estate...
All right, if we come down to our timeline here, we can see what's going on. We have the word the...
The 200...
Which is good, but right here, this is where it says 237, and Descript didn't pick that up, so we just need to adjust that. And the way we do that is we come over here to this 237, this word, 237, even though it's a number. Get right over that split. We're going to hold down Control, and we see our bracket is open to the right, and that means we will be adjusting the content that's to the right, which is good because we want to click and then drag the 237 all the way over to here to meet up with the. So let's back up and try this again.
Ocean. The 237-acre estate.
That's exactly what we were looking to do. To pop these titles on the rest of our scenes, just going to go back and hit them. We did the first one. Second one, there won't be anything to adjust here. We just need to make sure we've got it on each one. I'm just clicking the scene over here on the left in the scene rail. And then I go up to the T in the insert menu. I click captions, and it's bringing in the exact same style of captions.
Briar patch. With. This waterfront is
just as we established them. Okay, next scene. Great. Next scene. And our last scene. There we go. Now that we've split everything up, we've cleaned everything up, we've applied our captions, our audio sounds good. The next thing we want to do is export. And there's a couple of ways that you can do this. One way is you can use publish and stay in the publish zone. It makes for very fast rendering. This will do the rendering in the cloud. And then you'll just download the video once it's been rendered. The issue here is that we've got one video here that we've split up into 10. So if we were to publish this now, it's going to publish it all as one thing, and we would still have to come back and split it out then. So that's probably not what we want to do. There isn't an option here to select in the settings that you want to publish by markers. The better way, I think, to do this is to go to publish and export, and then under export, instead of current composition, we say marker. We leave our resolution or change it if you want, however that is, and then we say export. Then we click the export button, and you'll see over here it starts exporting. Now these are going to render and then export to the folder that you selected right here locally, and it'll tell us it's got 10 out of 10. So it's going to export 10 videos separately. Because we said to export by markers, the title of each video is going to be whatever we made that marker. It'll download all 10 of those videos there. And then you can grab them and upload them wherever you're going with them. So you have your 10 videos all split apart in separate files, ready to upload. While this is working, we can go walk the dog, have a snack, work on something else, and let all 10 of those run out. And then we'll come back and upload them to whatever platform we're working on. They'll be exported to whatever folder you designate. I chose downloads. You can put them somewhere specific or special if you like, and then that's where you'll find them when it's done. And just like that, our video export is completed. We can take a look in the downloads folder where I told Descript to export these videos by marker.
And sure enough, there are our 10 videos ready to go and upload. We started from one, we split it up into 10, we cleaned it up a little bit, we put the captions on there, and we are ready to go with 10 short form vertical videos. Hey, take a look at this video that is on the right side of your screen right now. I hope you find it helpful.